Motorcyclist killed in a hit-and-run crash is remembered, and tonight a suspect is charged in his death. New at 10, 12 News' Terry Sater is at the scene. Terry, there was an emotional gathering for the victim tonight.
That's right. A lot of hugs and tears here earlier for a fundraiser for funeral expenses at the Nostalgia 2 nightclub. Police say the suspect in this case had a blood alcohol of 0.17, and that's especially difficult for the victim's father, who used to respond to drunk driving crashes.
Dear Father, thank you for waking us up today to see the brightness of another day. Thank you for waking us up to see each other again.
Locked arm in arm in prayer, members of the Bogus Boys Motorcycle Club mourn the loss of one of their own, Hal Boston's son.
Brandon was a good kid. Everybody says, hey, Brandon was great. He was a good friend. You can call him anytime. And as a parent, that's what you like to hear about your kids.
Milwaukee police say 24-year-old Brandon Boston on his motorcycle was killed late Saturday night by a hit-and-run driver who had a blood alcohol level more than twice the legal limit. Brandon's father, a retired Milwaukee firefighter, is honored by the support of other firefighters and a fundraiser from members of the club his son co-founded.
What Brandon was like, in my eyes, he was like Superman. It wasn't nothing that Brandon couldn't do. If he couldn't do it, he'd sit for a week and go back to work and perfect it and bring it back to you, and he'd master his accomplishment. He was the type of individual that everybody would want in their life.
The criminal complaint against 47-year-old Michael Dorsey says Dorsey stated that he had a previous OWI in 2001, that on Saturday night he was making a left turn and somebody hit him at Green Bay Road in Congress. Police say he turned in front of Brandon's motorcycle.
Whatever punishment that he get behind it, and willing more, he gets what he deserves, but at the same time, it doesn't bring Brandon back.
When you're going and you are drunk two times, three times, four times, you got a serious problem that needs to be taken care of. And we definitely do not need to have these people back on the street.
Police say the suspect told them he knew someone had hit his vehicle, but he was scared, and that's why he left the scene. He is charged with homicide by intoxicated use of a motor vehicle. He could face up to 25 years in prison if convicted on that charge, as well as the second charge for leaving the scene. Live in Milwaukee, Terry Sater, WISN 12 News.